explaining how to determine the melting point of the given organic solid. So here what we do is, an unknown organic solid is given to us and we have to determine what is the exact melting point of that particular solid. So as you know, like that of the boiling point, even the melting point is specific to that particular compound. And before going on to the experiment, let me just tell what is meant by melting point. So melting point is that temperature at which the solid and the liquid phases of that particular compound coexist, or in other words I can tell, the solid and the liquid phases are in equilibrium. Or I can also define this melting point in simple terms, that is, melting point is that temperature at which the solid just gets converted into its liquid form. So here in this experiment we are finding out what is that exact temperature at which the solid gets converted into its liquid form. So the given organic compound is taken on a clean surface and then we have to powder it. So why this powdering is done? Because if we have this fine powder only, then we can fill this organic compound into the capillary tube. Because to find the melting point, we need to fill the capillary tube with this organic compound. So to fill it, we need to convert this into fine powder. So this is the first prerequisite step which we need to do before moving on to the main experimental part. So here we know that this is the capillary. So capillary is open on both the sides. Now what we need to do is, we need to fill the organic solid which is given inside this capillary. So for filling the organic solid, we need to seal one end of the capillary, because since both the sides are open, we need to close one side of the capillary so that we can fill the organic solid into this capillary tube. So for this sake, how to seal this capillary tube? We need to heat one end of the capillary tube in the Bunsen burner so that it will be sealed. So this is the next prerequisite of this experiment. So the first one was, as I've told, it was powdering the organic compound. So you can use the method which I have told, or also you can use a moderate pestle for bringing about the powdering of the solid. So the second prerequisite is sealing one end of the capillary by heating in the Bunsen burner. So here you can see, I am holding this capillary, the end of the capillary tube, in the flame. And when you heat it, you have to just observe whether the end of the capillary tube has been sealed because of the heat of the flame. So what you have to do is, you have to heat and observe whether it is sealed. But you have to be very careful that you should not overheat the capillary tube, because if it is overheated, it will cause bending of the capillary tube. So it should not bend, it should just be sealed at the end. So you can see that the capillary tube has been, the end of the capillary tube has been sealed here. So we have the capillary tube which is open in one end and which is sealed at the other end. Now we have the sealed capillary as well as the organic compound here, which is already powdered. So now what we have to do is, we have to fill this organic compound, the powdered organic compound, into this capillary. So what we have to do is, to fill this, we just need to place this capillary on the organic compound like this. So you can see that the organic compound has entered into the capillary tube, right? So what we need to do is, this organic compound has to move to the other side of the capillary, that is the sealed side of the capillary. So for this sake, we need to turn this capillary upside down and we have to just tap this capillary on the other side so that the organic compound will start collecting at the bottom of this capillary tube, so that here on the sealed end of the capillary tube, this organic compound will start collecting. So just we need to tap it. So the next step is tying this capillary tube to this thermometer. Now when we tie this capillary tube to this thermometer also, we should be very careful. That is, the end of the capillary tube and the end of the thermometer should be in the same line. So what we have to do is, we are finding out the melting point of this organic compound which is there in this capillary tube. So for that sake we are tying it with the thermometer with the help of this thread. Just note this, the level of these two, the ends of thermometer and the capillary tube. The thermometer along with the capillary tube is fixed into the Thiele's tube. So what we have to do is, in order to calculate the melting point, we have to fix the thermometer and the capillary tube together, which is placed inside the Thiele's tube. Now, inside the Thiele's tube, we have filled the paraffin oil, okay, or in other words, we can also call it as liquid paraffin. So why we need to use this liquid paraffin? Because liquid paraffin has a very high boiling point. So suppose we use any other solvent instead of this, any other liquid, then the boiling point will be low. So then what might happen if the liquid also boils? Then it will disturb the experiment. It will disturb the proper recording of the melting point. So here, since the paraffin oil has a very high boiling point, it does not disturb with the normal procedure of the experiment. So that's why inside the Thiele's tube we fill the paraffin oil. So the next step is we have to heat the side arm of the Thiele's tube. Okay, so even while heating, we should be very careful that the liquid, that is the Thiele's tube, and the liquid within the Thiele's tube is not overheated. So we should heat it at a constant rate so that only the side arm of this Thiele's tube is heated. What we have to do is, during this method, we have to continuously monitor the temperature rise in the thermometer. So we have to see simultaneously the rise in the temperature as well as the compound which is placed within the capillary tube. So we have to be very alert in this experiment. So as soon as the compound melts in the capillary tube, we have to immediately see the temperature in the thermometer. So it is completely different from that of boiling point, because in boiling point the boiling temperature remains constant for certain seconds. But here it's not like that. The temperature is continuously rising. So we have to be very careful. We have to observe the melting, that is the compound, when it will just start melting, and simultaneously we have to immediately see the temperature at which the compound will melt. So now we can just see the compound has started melting. Okay. And then we can see immediately we have to see the temperature at which the compound has started melting. So here the temperature at which the compound has started melting is 120 degrees Celsius. So here we can see the compound has melted. Okay. So now we are done with the experimental part. So we have got that, we have seen in the experiment that at 120 degrees Celsius the compound has just melted. So we can report the melting point of the given organic compound as 120 degrees Celsius. Okay. So usually what we do is, for reporting purposes, since there may be some personal error, okay, it may not be very accurate when we just, since we have to observe both, that is the melting